Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to use Google Gemini 3 Pro AI models on Antigravity AI code editor. So you are going to build some apps and going to show you how to use this very popular Gemini 3 Pro models for building apps. So you have to first install Antigravity, and for that I have already made a very detailed video, so you can follow that video to know how to install Antigravity, then how to sign in. So you can see I have done all of that on my previous video, so I am signed in now using Google Auth. So now it's time to build something amazing using AI, of course. So it's going to be all Vive coding. So to start with, let's ask something to Google Gemini. So let's tell Gemini, build a web app of game tic-tac-toe where I'll be playing against computer. So whenever I'm going to play, computer going to give their next move. So build it using JavaScript with attractive UI. So very simple prompt. So just give something and you can select your model. So we are going to use Gemini 3 Pro High. On my previous videos, I have showed you how to use this Cloud Sonnet 4.5 model and how you can build apps and all that. So all those videos are already present on our channel. Let's try this time Gemini 3 Pro. So give this and click on send. It's going to immediately start building our app. So building the tic-tac-toe app. You can see task. And now it started implementing all the tasks that we have created and creating our project. So now it started writing application code. So creating HTML index.html file. Here is our index.html file. Next, style.css file is also created, and script.js file as well. You can see here is our script.js file. Now it's rightly started verifying even. It is asking for some permission. Just click on this. Click on Agent Manager. So welcome to Agent Manager. Click on Next. Let's set a local folder. So click on local folder and let's browse it to our codes folder. So this is our Agent Manager. So here you can click on this trust folder and continue. So now our folder is rightly set for Agent Manager. You can minimize this for now. And here you can click on setup. So it's going to launch it on browser by opening our application. You can also click on accept changes in each of this file so that all changes are recorded. And here it opened on our browser. So you need to set it up for Google Antigravity. So just simply install that extension. So you can maximize it and just simply click on add to Chrome. Add extension, and now it has opened the URL on our browser. So that's Vive coding, man. So you don't need to do anything. You just write a prompt right on this chat window. It's not only going to create your app, it's going to also deploy and going to open it for you. By the way, you need to click on this accept changes so that all changes are right over here. So it's done now. Implementation plan, everything you can see. But the main project is consists of these three files, index.html, style.css and script.js. And here is our application opened. So now it is actually testing. So it not only create your app, it is also started testing. So if you see here, it is verifying the game functionality right now. So that is exactly what it is doing right now, you can see. So computer's turn, your turn, again it is mimicking my turn and just simply testing this application whether it is working properly or not. This is another level, man. I really like this functionality. So it has found some error while clicking sale 1, so it is fixing that. Now I'll check restart game button. So you can literally see what it is actually doing. It's not just doing this testing, it is parallelly documenting each and single steps as well. Now it is verifying reset and replay button. So you can see it's again refresh, open the URL in browser, getting DOM, clicking element, center cell. So center cell, proxy, zero has been given by computer. Again, you can see that restart game button just clicked. Amazing. So that's Gemini 3 Pro. So now you can see game flow and reset functionality are now working correctly. And finally, you can see it is done. So I have finished the task. So these are all changes it has done on all these files, index.html, style.css, and finally script.js as well. And you can see it has also created a walkthrough.md file. So that's markdown file. So this is our markdown file. And here is our application. So you can restart game and start playing. So I'll give this computer play that. I'll give this computer play that. I'm going to defend it. Again, I'm going to defend it. And it's a draw. So restart game. I need to defend it. Again, it's going to be a draw. So very tricky, huh? Very hard to beat. No chance to beat. Computer wins. No chance to win at all. Yeah, you can't win. But that's vibe coding, man. You can see it not only created this application, it did full rounds of unit testing and then verified and deployed, and it finally our app. So the thing is, this is not a very complicated app, it's a very simple app. So there is no thing as such as deploying, it's just an index.html file. So it's not a complicated one, and the game itself is also very simple, but you understand the point. The next thing that I'm going to try is maybe creating a bit complex app. So maybe I'll be trying creating a Twitter-like website, or let's say a Facebook-like websites. So how you do that? And I'm going to also test backend codes as well, like how it creates those database codes and all that. And then it also how we deploy our project. So that's also I'm very eager to see. But that for my next video. That's all for this video. Please do check out my other videos. I'm sure you are going to love them. So that is basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.